Welcome to this Camtasia Studio 2019 tutorial for beginners, where in only 18 minutes, I'm gonna show you everything there is to know about how to make amazing videos. My name is Eduard Stinga, founder of Videoplasty, and let's get started. All right, so people use Camtasia for two reasons. On one hand, it's an absolutely amazing video editing software. It's user-friendly, and I absolutely love it. And on the other hand, you can also record your screen to do one of those screen capture videos. To begin with, I'm going to show you how to edit in Camtasia, and then at the end, I'm going to show you how you can do a screen recording. Also on the opening screen as well, you can see some tutorials here if you want to find out more. But let's just click on new project and start editing a video. Alright, so now let's understand a bit the fundamentals of how a video editing software works. You have three important screens here. On the left, you have the media bin with a lot of other tabs as well, which I suggest you feel free to explore a bit later. On the right, where right now it's completely black, we have the preview screen where we're gonna see how our video looks and behaves. And on the bottom is basically the heart of any video editing software. This is called the timeline. And we have multiple tracks and this thing right here, which we cannot drag right now because we don't have anything, but basically it goes from zero and all the way to 15 seconds, 30 seconds, and so on, depending on how long our video is. All right, so first things first, let's import some footage or media files into our project. So I already have those two videos selected here. I'm just gonna drag and drop them here in the media bin. And as you can see here, to make it super easy for us, Camtasia already generated some thumbnails, so we know which video is what. And if you hover your mouse over the video and just do this, you can actually scroll through it to see what this video is actually about, which is pretty cool. All right, so in order to add this video, I'm just gonna drag and drop it here on the timeline on the first track. And then I'm just gonna drag and drop this other video here as well. You can use this right here with minus and plus to zoom in on the timeline or to zoom out depending on how long you make your video, but I'm just gonna zoom in so it's a bit easier for us. Depending on the media footage you select, it can have some audio in the background like it does here. You can see the waveform, and this other clip right here doesn't have anything. And the way Camtasia works, it actually imports the video and the audio on the same track, but to make it easier to manipulate those, you want to separate them into different tracks. So the way you do that is you right click on the video here and click separate video and audio. And there you go, it generated this new track, which is just the audio. And as you can see here with the waveform, we can just play around with this to control the volume, make it louder, or just make it quiet in the background. And now, for example, if you click play, you're just gonna see here in the preview window how your video looks like. And it's gonna start at this point right here. So this is the tool that you use to move through the video and start in the beginning, or just check how it looks here, 15 seconds in and so on. So you can just click play and see how it works. All right, so for this one, it's just a guy playing the guitar, and pretty standard stuff. For example, we can just make this a bit more quiet in the background. All right, and here's the place where you start manipulating the videos. You just move them around. Maybe you want this to start a bit earlier, for example, or one really important tool that I use all the time is, let's say for example, you just wanna use this much of the video all the way to here with this aerial shot that looks pretty cool. And you use this tool right here called split. And what it does is just gonna split the video in half, and you can just move this to the right and just right click, delete it, and just use this part right here. But say for example, you change your mind later, you can just use the end right here and just click and drag to extend it all the way to where it was initially. Or for example, you want to use this clip again in a different part of the video, you're just gonna right click, copy, and then just move here, for example, and just gonna paste the media at the playhead. And now we have two copies of the same video, but I'm just gonna delete this one. So basically that's a super easy way to just make your media files longer, shorter, and just play around with them and see what works for you. Now, a really important concept to understand is the order of the tracks right here. The way Camtasia and basically any other video editing software works is it's going to use this as the priority in which you want to see the videos. So this one right here on track number 3, because it's on top of everything else, is just going to play here before everything else. So the way it works, it actually, like, because this video is here on the bottom, it still plays, but it's actually behind this, oops, it's actually behind this this other video on top, right? So if you play it back, right, you can see both playing, but only because I resized it. So basically that's how the track order works. But in order to understand it a bit better, let me just go to the library and drop a transparent icon as well. Let's just say, I don't know, calculator. Drop it here. All right. So again, as you can see, the calculator right here, because this one is transparent, it doesn't cover the whole screen. Even if it's on top, you can still see behind it because it's transparent, and it's just a small icon. However, if we move this track on the bottom below this aerial shot, all of a sudden we don't see it anymore. Even if, technically speaking, the calculator is still behind right there, as you can see it here, and on top of the guitar in the background. Now, as you can see, if you go here, you can already start manipulating the videos by dragging the corner, for example. But to gain even more flexibility, what you want to do is you go here to properties. And you're going to see here on the right, actually, let me just import this guitar video again here and use this as an example. So as you can see here on the right, we have two properties. Here we have the audio properties for this video, which has the audio as well. You can just play around with the volume, as you can do here at the same time on the timeline, is the exact same thing. And if you go here, you have visual properties, which are basically scale. You can just play around with this. You can play around with the opacity and make it transparent. You can just rotate it. You can do a lot of things with this and just be a bit more specific with the position from here. But to be honest, it's much easier to just manipulate it like this. In order to rotate it, you can just use this and it's just going to snap where it's more natural, like 90 degrees, 45, and that kind of thing. Also, you can use the corners to drag it around and resize it. It's super easy. And for example, when you're done with those changes, and for example, you don't like them, you can just go here on the right and click this button to just reset all the settings and go all the way to the beginning. Also, sometimes you might want to crop the video, and the way you crop the video is by using this tool right here. So now you can see if we move this selection, it's just going to keep the same scale, but cut everything else. So for example, if we now have this aerial video in the background, as you can see, that's the way this crop works to reveal what's underneath the video. So then you can just use this and move it around here, for example. All right, one cool thing about the properties for audio, for example, is that you can control this over time by adding keyframes. And the way you do this is you go here, for example, and you just double click and you start adding a couple of points. So now, for example, I can just drag this all the way down for whatever reason, and then it's going to go back to 100% volume. So let's see how that sounds like. Yep. I mean, you can use this to create a fade in when you start the track, and then maybe at the end you want it to slowly fade out. So I'm just going to add another point here, drop it all the way to 0%, and it's just a nice fade out of the music. Also, for example, you might want to play around with the speed of the video, for example. So the way you do that is you right click on this video and just add clip speed. And what's going to happen is you have this thing right here and you can just drag it to the right. Right now at 1x speed is basically the normal speed. But let's say we want that at 2x speed. It's just going to be double the speed, but half the time, basically. All right, that looks a bit weird. At the same time, you can also make it You can also make it in slow motion. So just drag this to the left, but I just need enough space to, all right, I'm just gonna move things around for a second. You need a bit more space. So let's just say almost 0.5x, which is half the speed. And let's just remove the calculator. And now if you play it back, it's a bit more in slow motion. You can just play around with it and see what works for you. Another thing that's really cool in Camtasia is that it's so user-friendly and has a lot of really cool things that you can use, such as a library of elements. And just feel free to explore all these tabs right here. There's absolutely nothing you can break, but unfortunately, we're not going to be able to cover all of them in this short 15-minute video. But let's have a quick look. For example, you can use a couple of music tracks right here, like this one. You just drag and drop it here if you need some music for your videos. But what's really interesting about Camtasia is that it has those things that you can actually edit, like a lower third, for example. So if I just drag and drop this here, it's a basic lower third. As you can see, it's going to show up here. But if I select this and go here to properties, I can actually edit this and say Camtasia tutorial. And also, I can change the logo to something else. I can change the shape. Just do that, whatever. I can change the color to black or white, whatever. I can change this other color here to red, and this white here, I can change it to black, and all sorts of things. I mean, black doesn't look that good, but you get the point, right? It just makes it so easy to use. You just drop it, do a couple of quick edits, and it just animates automatically. Super, super useful. I'm just going to remove it. Another thing that you want to look at is transitions, because those are absolutely amazing. Well, in most cases, you want to use a fade because it's pretty much the most elegant thing you can use. But for example, just play around with this. Let's say we want to have a look at flip, right? So the way you use this is you drag and drop it to this clip on top aerial, for example. And as you can see here, it already created the transition, and I can just make it longer or shorter. In this case, it even tells me how long it is. Let's say it's 2 seconds. So let's have a look at how that actually behaves. So we start with this video in the background, and I just click play, and we're going to see the other video flipping. There you go. Pretty cool stuff. And of course, if you want to add a fade out at the end, I mean, not a fade out, but like another animation, whatever you're into, I don't know, let's just say cube rotate, and just move it here. Let's see how that behaves. There you go. And there's a lot of other cool things as well that you can add. Just feel free to explore. We're not going to have time to cover them all here. For example, you can just play around with this. Let's say you want to add this visual effect right here. So I'm just going to drop it here. And as you can see, it changed the color of this video. And you can play around with the settings here. Just adjust the intensity. Maybe you want to ease in, which basically means it's going to start after 2 seconds. So for example, let's remove the transition to see how this effect is going to start now. So it starts as a colored video, as you can see, but after 2.8 seconds, it's going to slowly start changing the color, as you can see. And maybe you're not happy with this and you just want to remove it. So you just go here and click on this X button to remove this filter. All right, that's all for editing videos in Camtasia. It's pretty straightforward. You just have to play around with it. And now let's have a quick look at how you can record your screen and do those screen capture videos. One way to do it is to use this button right here, or if you go to the main open window when you start Camtasia, just click there. Let's have a quick look at that. All right, so back to the opening screen. If you want to do a screen recording, you're just going to click here on new recording. And here you can play around with a lot of settings. If you have multiple displays, you can just select them here, or you can just resize this window. In most cases, I suggest you just go for a full screen recording. I'm just gonna go back to, what was it? The name of the display. If you have multiple displays, it's gonna show up here. You can also select what microphone you wanna use to record. In my case, I'm just gonna use the Blue Yeti compared to the built-in microphone. Because if you have a separate mic, it's just gonna be much higher quality. Also, you can select to record the audio of the computer as well or not, just disable it or enable it according to your needs. And if you want to do one of those screen recordings where it records the webcam as well, on the bottom right, you can do so here, as you can see. So let's just do a quick recording and see how that's gonna behave. All right, just gonna move this around, open this. All right, and then when we are done, I'm just gonna right click here and stop recording. All right, so now we are back in Camtasia, and as you can see, we already have those two video tracks here on the timeline. And the cool thing about doing this in Camtasia is that if you record your webcam as well, it's just gonna add it here as a separate track, which basically allows you a lot of freedom to do whatever you want with it. You can just resize it, make it larger, change the corner. Maybe you want to put it in the top left corner for whatever reason. But most people just do it here bottom right, just because I don't even know, actually, it just looks good there. But basically it gives you a lot of freedom to do that. And that's pretty much it. Like, you're gonna edit the video. If you need to edit a couple of parts out, maybe you wanna remove, I don't know, whatever part here, you do it the exact same way that I taught you a few minutes ago. And now let's talk about saving the project and exporting the video. You gotta understand the difference between saving your project in Camtasia by using this save tab right here. This is just gonna save the project file so you can continue editing the project later. But when you're done and you wanna export the project into a video, what you wanna do is you go here on the top right where it says share, and you have a lot of options as well, but we're just gonna stick with local file. And just title it Camtasia tutorial export or whatever file name, just browse on your computer wherever you want to save it. And in terms of settings, I would stick with either MP4 or MOV. And for the options, to be honest, unless you know what you're doing, I would just leave everything as it is by default, and then you click export. And it's going to take a while because exporting videos is not that easy on the processor, but that's basically how you do it. Alright, I hope you enjoyed this Camtasia Studio 2019 video tutorial for beginners. Be sure to smash that like button if you enjoyed this video, it really helps with the YouTube algorithm. And make sure to subscribe to this channel for more tutorials on how to make amazing videos. And if you're interested to make some sort of animation in Camtasia, be sure to check out videoplasty.com and see all of the stock animation that we have available. It's basically pre-animated elements that you can add as a library in Camtasia, and then you just drag and drop them on the timeline. Super easy to use and super amazing. All right, my name was Edward Singer from Videoplasty, and I'll see you soon.